Well, welcome back to the workshop. Today we're going to tackle what I regard as something of a rite of passage in the world of Land Rovers, and that is changing a diff pinion seal. Virtually everyone who buys a Land Rover, the first thing they've got to do, well, they look underneath it and they check out the oil leaks, and invariably there's oil pouring out of one of the diffs. It's a little bit more complicated on a Salisbury axle potentially, but on these Rover diffs it's quite simple, and it really is just a case of removing this nut, pulling the dry flange off, prising the seal out, pressing the new one in, and do it all again in reverse. But there's one or two things where you can make it easier for yourself. There's one or two places where you could come to grief with the job, so we'll have a look at it. I had been intending to rebuild this diff, which came out of the vehicle. It's an original. It's actually in very nice condition. I've gradually been making some of the special tools to do it, as shown in the handbook. So I'll keep working my way through that, and eventually we'll get round to it. Also got a new prop shaft to fit today. There's quite a bit of wear in the sliding joint, which is something they suffer. That's moving all the time, whether you've got through wheel hubs or not. Got a new seal. I think I've got all the bits I need, so let's go and have a look at the vehicle. First thing to do is drain the oil from the front diff. Before we do that, we're just going to make sure we can get the filler plug out. Right, well, there's not an awful lot of room in here, but it is better now the vehicle's on parabolic springs. That is another advantage of those, a bit of lift at the body, so you know, the chassis sits higher, a bit more room under the sump at least. What's wrong with this front prop? Well, the universal joints are alright, but there's a lot of play in the sliding joint, which you won't really be able to see, but it's causing a lot of vibration going down the road. And then there's a bit of an oil leak there, and of course it can flick oil on the tyre, so it's not ideal. It's not much, but we'll get to it now. Not really any easy way of doing this, but I'm going to try and break these off with a pair of spanners. Well, we'll just leave that hanging on for a minute to just give it some support. In fact, we don't need to do that, it rests on the chassis. A little bit of backlash here is normal,
I can feel just that much before it takes up drive, which is very good. You see some that are like that, probably want to have a look at it if it's like that. Yeah, sometimes getting on these is a real pain. That's one of the reasons I'm using the spanners like this, just pulling them together with one hand, because if you slip, you're not going to gash your knuckles on the sharp bits on the chassis. It's one thing I have learned to do over the years. Trying to get them at a reasonable offset so I can pull them together with one hand. So that's what all the faffing about is. Right, we've now got to get the drive flange off the pinion. So I've got a 6-point socket for this. Unfortunately it's a long socket, but I think it'll be alright because there's quite a high torque on that. So the thing is now to stop it turning. And what you could do is engage the hubs, but you're then putting a lot of stress through it all. But more than that, it's trying to move the vehicle. And that's a big no-no if you've got, say, the back end up on the axle stands already. So, I don't know if it's going to work for us today, but I made this thing to do the rear diff pinion a long time ago. Just a bit of scrap steel. So I'm just going to bolt it up to the drive flange and hopefully it'll do the job. Let's see what happens. Yeah, that's got it. Now get to that awkward stage where nothing quite fits. You can see why people put these off and just let them leak. Right, there she goes. Yeah. So at this point, once this comes off, you'll see that this one has, well, I don't know how many splines, but must be something about 20 odd splines. Some diffs you'll take this off and see only 4 splines. Doesn't matter, but just make sure you get the right drive flange if you're replacing it. Oh yeah, and the spacer that runs inside the seal, probably a good idea not to drop that. I say that, the seal actually runs on this face here, on the drive flange, but anyway, spacer must go back in. This one doesn't look too bad, it's a bit of wear as you'd expect, but obviously to work properly the diff relies on that being tightened up properly. Right, we get the seal out next. Well, I've got a variety of implements here, so we'll see if we can't lever the seal out. There are proper tools for this, but I've never spent money on anything like that. Probably should. Goes.
Seal doesn't look that bad. There's a little bit of rust on the pinion, which I think is probably what's caused it to leak, but nothing that won't polish out. The new seal is slightly different, but it's all the right sizes, so we're not going to have an issue with that. This actually has a Land Rover part number on it, so I'll keep that as a sample for next time. I've just packed the inside with a bit of grease. The handbook suggests a bit of sealant on the outside, so I'm just going to stick some of my favourite around the periphery of the seal, clean up the nose of the diff and tap it in. For this I've got, I think it's perhaps an old gearbox bearing, anyway, transfer box bearing perhaps, which happens to be about the right size to tap that in, and a piece of tube as well, which is a very close fit. So I think with those, we'll be able to drive that in okay.
There's actually a register in the nose of the diff. And we can actually drive it into that, so it'll be slightly recessed in the nose. The seal's in there dead square now, I can see that, and it's right up against the register. So the next thing is to pop the spacer through. And then I've cleaned up the drive flange. We've got some grease on there as well, and on the splines. Thank you. And the next thing will be to get some Loctite for the bolt. Put the stay bar on there again and tighten her up. Put a bit of Loctite on this bolt. The torque given for this is 85 pound foot. Feels like it's all moved freely, so that's fine. One final check up.
In these packs of prop shelf bolts, you often get these long ones. I found that they're not a lot of good you actually want for the front prop. Four of these shorter bolts. Physically there's room for those to fit, but I think I'm right in saying the thread isn't quite long enough. But anyway, these are just long enough, no exposed thread, but just enough for the nylock to do its bit. For some reason people always seem to, very often seem to get these the wrong way round. The sliding joint in the prop shaft needs to be at the diff end. And the solid end up here by the transfer box. Just get a couple of bolts in so it will hang there. See, these shorter bolts are just long enough for the nylock to get on and do its thing, but not a lot of exposed thread to rust up and get stuck later on. I've certainly never had prop shelf bolts work loose on me. But when I first had the MGB, it was about a month before I got under it and had a look. I hadn't realised all that time that the prop shelf bolts were only finger tight. You could get hold of them and just turn them.
But you wouldn't know it from behind the wheel. That was the amazing thing.
Anyway, It's glad I got onto that when I did. We are all back together, topped up with oil, and ready for a test drive.
I've just done one other little job, and that's to change the mud flaps from nice new old stock ones. I painted the brackets some time ago, they'd gone a bit rusty in storage, but much better quality than the aftermarket ones. Let's go for a drive and see how she goes.
Set the job was a success, no oil leak, and the vibration at the front axle is gone, so very pleased with that. Had hoped to put the onboard camera on, but the got a problem with the mount, so I need to sort that out. Anyway, hope the video is useful, hope you enjoyed it, and thanks very much for watching.